brothers and sisters.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus be always with you.
And your spirit.
As we prepare ourselves now to receive God's holy word, let us ask pardon for our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. One God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep. And if you are called, reply, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence. calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and you will see." So they went and saw where Jesus was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 p.m. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord. So there was an old man who thought that his wife might be developing a hearing problem. So one night he stood behind her while she was sitting in her lounge chair. And he spoke softly to her, "Honey, can you hear me?" There was no response. So he moved a little closer and said again, "Honey, can you hear me?" Still no response. Finally, he moved right behind her chair and said, "Honey, can you hear me?" She replied, "For the third time, yes." "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." Listening is a skill that many of us have tried to improve upon since we were children. Perhaps you've seen that parent holding their child's face in their hand saying, "Listen to me." Maybe you've been that parent. It's a method to get the child to move away from whatever is distracting them, their restlessness, an injury, sadness, to refocus them, get them from the distraction. The parent's conveying that the child is looking, wants them to be paying attention so that they can get a message of instruction or healing or comfort so that they can protect their child. And that distraction from listening is not limited to children. Listening is a skill that many adults often continue to struggle with throughout their lives, in their marriages, in their workplaces, in our families, and in our faith life. Imagine for a moment, if you will, God the Father, your Abba, taking your face in his hands, looking into your eyes and saying to you, "Listen to me." What instruction or healing or comfort are you seeking from your Father that he desires to provide? If we want to receive that instruction or healing or comfort from God, we need to be open to listening. There was a TED Talk series that I am aware of. It's called How to Be a Better Human. And one episode dealt with listening. And it had some insights that I thought could help us to become better listeners in our spiritual life. Now, listening might not be the most exciting part of the conversation, but it's essential if we want to have a meaningful exchange with God that we listen. Our relationship requires both speaking and listening. And I'll admit, I'm a little challenged by the latter. And why? Well, one reason is if you rearrange those six letters in the word listen, you get another word, silent. I don't do silent so well. I try, but I have a tendency to fall back on those distractions. They might be physical distractions, doing things around the house, running an errand, whatever it might be. And the mental distractions, the news feeds, other things that occupy my thoughts and mind. But when I think about how God revealed his presence to Samuel and calling out to him, he called out in the silence of the night when there were no distractions. While God doesn't always address us in the silence, it is a practical place for us to put ourselves in order to hear what he has to say to us. So what are those places? The Adoration Chapel, perhaps, Mass, outdoors by the ocean, the lake, in the mountains, jogging, biking, and maybe even driving to work. There are many places where God might find you to call on you. And note as well what God was calling Samuel to. He was taking the initiative to invite Samuel to a relationship with him. The reading states that Samuel was not familiar with the Lord. Samuel was young, I think maybe around 11 years old. And while he knew in his mind that he was serving God, he hadn't developed that familiarity yet with God. He didn't have a relationship or a close friendship with God in his heart. Of course, if you read further in the book of Samuel, you see that that gets developed. And God invites us in the same way to a relationship of the heart that we can develop over our lifetime. And we need to be open. "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening," is a phrase that invites us to be led by the Lord. This requires that we discern what we are hearing and be trusting enough to respond. Now, I can't say that I've ever spoken those words myself, but in words and actions of other ways, I can recall where I have allowed myself to be led by God in my vocation, both in my marriage and in the diaconate. God is relentless in his desire to invite us into a relationship with him, so relentless that he sent his son to us to illustrate the depth of his love for us, for God so loved the world. Today's gospel reading from John reinforces the importance of listening, hearing an invitation, being open to respond in our own spiritual life. At the beginning of the reading, we see John the Baptist totally understands who Jesus is, humbly points his disciples toward Jesus, saying, "Behold the Lamb of God." Having listened, the disciples, their interest is piqued, and they're open to the idea, and they begin to follow Jesus. At that point, you might say that the two disciples were not familiar with the Lord Jesus Christ in the same way that Samuel was not familiar with God. But then, like Samuel, the two disciples receive an invitation. Jesus begins by asking them, "What are you looking for?" This is a question that Jesus asks each of us. Then, like a lot of us, caught off guard by the question and unable to really answer directly, they deflect by asking a question. "Where are you staying?" And Jesus then extends his invitation. "Come and you will see." Eventually, through the interaction that happens in the gospel today, they begin the initial steps of developing that relationship with Jesus. His invitation meant joining him in public ministry, listening to his teaching, imitating his lifestyle. Their yes to that invitation would take them to places they never expected. So where could the relationship take us if we opened ourselves up by listening, really listening to the invitation that Jesus offers us? I think it's fair to say that there are numerous distractions in our lives, that we are assailed by many forms of information and disinformation in today's world that can lead us in a variety of directions, some helpful, some harmful. The readings from the book of Samuel and the Gospel of John encourage us to be attentive in our faith, to work on our listening skills, that we might hear God's invitations to instructions or healing or comfort, and that we be open and willing to respond to what is asked of us. So find that place that works for you, that silent place. Have the courage to say those words, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." And then listen for what God desires to say to you.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Father of mercies, we approach you with our petitions and the needs of our families and friends.
For our incoming president, to have before him at all times the charge to protect and defend the rights of all citizens, especially the weakest and most vulnerable among us. Let us pray to the Lord. For the people of the United States, to engage in a spirit of cooperation, tranquility, and respect for one another, and for all human life as good stewards of the gifts God has given us. Let us pray to the Lord. for the righteous who struggle against racism and violence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this community who put their commitment to justice into practical action, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Mass is being offered for Dilbert Dowing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Adam, Andrew, Luke, William, Abby, Gio, McKenna, Sydney, Nicole, and all of our children whose health is vulnerable and recovering from illnesses. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Katie, Leah, Jocelyn, Kelly, Martha, Danielle, Megan, and all the young mother expecting mothers. That God will bless their pregnancies. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
And we pray for Kaylin with Neve and Jules with Madison and all the young mothers, that God will bless their relationship with their children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
And we pray for Richard, for Andy, Anna, Neil, Peter, Justin, Grant, Kenneth, Tom, Paula, Jeff and Wally, for all of our friends who are recovering from surgery or who suffer from cancer and other illnesses, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
And we pray for Alan Dickerson, who died from COVID, and from all the people that we know who suffer from COVID, and for Della, who passed away recently. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
please hear our prayers. Help our country to learn from its failures and mistakes, just as we try to learn from our successes. This we pray through Christ our Lord. Sisters and brothers, that these our gifts be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that we should give you thanks and praise, O God, Almighty Father, for all you do in this world, through our Lord Jesus Christ. For though the human race is divided by dissension and discord, yet we know that by testing us, you change our hearts to prepare them for reconciliation. Even more, by your Spirit, you move human hearts, that enemies may speak to each other again, adversaries join hands, and peoples seek to meet together. By the working of your power, it comes about, O Lord, that hatred is overcome by love, revenge gives way to forgiveness, and discord is changed to mutual respect. Therefore, as we give you ceaseless thanks with the choirs of heaven, we cry out to your majesty on earth as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord.
Son, who comes in your name. He is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we have turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free at the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. May he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, and all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her beloved husband, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship, bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray that each one of us can be instruments of God's peace in our country. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. Keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever."
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Of the world. Blessed are those called to his banquet. Series on television called The Chosen, It was made with an awful lot of love. It's about the life of Jesus, and it's worthwhile. It can get your mind off of all the problems in our country. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart. Please bless Adam, Joe, and Andrew. Help them to leave the hospitals soon. This we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying God by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God.